We want to go find our very first cow.
We're going cow shopping.
This is livestock. It's our first animal on the farm. Pretty pumped.
Hi, cow. This is a girl cow.
Yep, that's a girl cow. So having a cow is our first animal. I feel like it's a great bang for the buck. I want to breed her, hopefully get more calves and cows out of it, and hopefully see a return on our investment.
He's like a dog. He's like a big, big dog, huh?
Hey, Nate.
Hey, guys.
How you doing, buddy?
Good. How you doing?
Good.
Hi.
Good to see you.
Yeah, this is my wife, Lauren.
Hey, nice to meet you.
And this is Juniper.
Hi, Juniper.
Hey, how are you?
Nice to meet you.
Richard's a new friend I just met who's got a family farm. We're still looking to figure out what kind of cow we want. A full-grown cow can get all the way up to like 1,400 pounds, I think, for bulls and stuff. It's just like, are we gonna be able to handle this?
Yeah. I don't think I'd trust you to handle all that.
These guys are tiny. They look super manageable. Richard and Laura have a small breed of cows that we're looking at, and they might be easier to manage. What do you think?
Yeah, I like them. They look easier.
We went and milked a big cow.
Right.
A little challenging. Oh, my God.
Like, hold it at the top, and then you push it down. Yep, just like that.
I can't see what I'm doing.
When you gotta milk a cow, people gotta get up in there. But for little people, we have short arms. So like, I'm right up in there, just, you know, like my head in the udder. And that's super intimidating. It's huge.
We have a couple of really small ones. You wanna go take a look at that?
Yeah, let's go take a look at that.
If you don't wanna have to be chasing cattle around on horseback, then I think these small cows are easier to handle. And I think for Nate's stature, it's gonna be a more manageable animal.
This is a cool breed, man.
This is Luna. Say
Luna.
Hi to Luna.
Hi, Luna.
Oh, she's giving me kisses. She's like a puppy.
I mean, did you see how cute they were? And they're following it, and they're like docile and pets.
I know.
And they're so cute. And that little one, that tiny little one.
We're not having pets. These are animals. These are livestock.
But
they're
they could be pets
food first. We are not doing a petting zoo.
What about that one?
What do you think, Lauren? Would you guys be willing to part with her?
I think so.
I think so. I think that you'd be really happy with her.
Okay.
You'll have a great opportunity to really start your farm.
You want to go with that one?
Yeah, let's do that. What are we going to name her?
Xana.
Xana.
I have no idea where that came from, but that's what we're sticking with.
That looks good.
Would you guys be up for helping us out and delivering it?
Yeah, I can give you a hand.
Yeah, that would definitely help us out. I'm so excited to do this. This is what I want for my family. I mean, if it doesn't work, it's definitely going to be a big letdown, and I don't want that to happen.
Thanks, sounds good.
Laura, thank you so
much. Thank you.
Hi.
Hi. How are you doing?
Good. We just went shopping, like, for a cow.
Nice. Are you excited? Are you a little excited?
I have no idea what I'm doing.
Yeah, I never would have pictured you living on a farm.
Me neither.
I know, it's a lot of adjustment. It's a lot.
My mom and I are really close. My mom was kind of the rock of the family. She was the one that was there all the time. My dad worked very hard to give us a great life. He'd come home and we'd play so hard together. I loved my dad, and he's a big softie. But my mom was the steady, constant, you know, I gotta take care of the family, I gotta keep this house clean, I gotta keep, you know, put dinner on the table. She's just my role model.
So what are you finding to do for fun?
Well, I'm slowly making friends.
Good. Maybe try to plan a little girls' date.
Yeah.
So you start feeling like it's more like home for you.
Yeah.
Have you found shopping places you need to go? And
we know where the farm stores are.
Try not to complain too much about it, because he really has been wanting to do this, and you want him to be happy, and he wants you to be happy too.
Of course.
Let's go see where we're gonna put Xana.
Can we get the hose?
Yep, we'll get the hose in a bit.
We gotta get a game plan.
We gotta get a game plan, what we're gonna do. So today is the day we get to bring our first animal onto the farm. Pretty excited about this. I feel like it's this dream that I've had is finally coming true. And it's like, this is happening. We got our first cow. First of many.
First of many.
Yeah. You know what we gotta do when she gets here?
What?
We gotta fill her up her water tank.
I'm just gonna stay back with Juniper, because who knows how that cow's gonna react to
she might be a little
getting
stressed.
Out in her new area, yeah.
I think after we get her today, I think we're ready for goats next.
I think we need to, like, live the cow life, see how we do with actual animals.
What? I want to, like, keep going.
For right now, we just need to slow down. I'm just now getting used to the fact that we have a cow. Nate is the kind of guy who just thinks he knows what he's doing. I'll just figure it out as I go along. I'm more like, let's figure out which plan works. But he's just, I think it's this way.
Oh, there it is. What is that? Is that our cow?
Yeah.
All right, well, you stay here. I'm gonna tell him where to go, okay?
Hey, buddy.
Hey, so I'm thinking we can make a shoot with that.
Yeah.
That way we don't have to move anything.
Yeah.
You wanna do that first?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, yeah. That should be good, right?
Yeah, I would imagine.
Growing up, being a little person in an average height family, my parents never focused on it. They never put glasses and plates down low, which we do now. I was like, hey, can you give me a glass? You can get your own glass. They're like, what are you gonna do when I'm not here? So I grew up with that mentality of, this is not who I am.
Yep.
Obviously, there's limitations to what I can and can't do, but it doesn't stop me from doing other things or finding a solution around the problem. Hey, come on, girl. Can we get behind her or no?
She may take a little coaxing to come out.
Come here, girl. Come on. Hold on. Ugh. She pretty ornery?
No, you know, anytime you move them, they get skittish and stressed.
She doesn't want to come out, so I'm going to get in there, try to get behind her, and hopefully that coerces her to go out the trailer.
Close that one.
Good luck with that one.
Yeah, that's not going to be fun.
There we go. Get under there and behind her.
There we go.
There she is.
That was pretty painless.
Look how cute she is. Stay here, please.
You sure she's not a calf? Holy cow.
No, that's...
She's tiny. Pretty excited. So, like, we are starting.
We have a cow.
We own a cow.
No turning back. We have a cow.
Yeah, I know.
Isn't this awesome?
She's cute.
I think this is going to be awesome. Not only for us, but for Juniper.
Now we just need a new baby.
Yeah. Yeah, I want to give you that happy ending, you know, in your dream as much as you gave me this. Seriously, thank you.
Awesome.
I love you.
Love you too.
Juniper!